Novak unleashes it to Novak. That's good.
Let's go with this player build, which honestly it took me over 5 hours because the entire time I was stuck making a center that was 6'11" and I couldn't get it working at all. I couldn't get the badges, I couldn't get what I wanted to do. So, and obviously I haven't played with this player builder for like 10 years, so it's very in-depth now. But I will show you what I ended up on. And watching lots of YouTube videos and things, I am trying to get some inspiration, but obviously not. I didn't actually copy anyone for this. Obviously, you can see what we're doing as we're doing it, but I'll explain what was important for the character I wanted to make. The driving dunk we got to 85, so that gives us... No, driving dunk was 86. That's a different screenshot. It's definitely 86. Because we wanted that limitless takeoff gold. We fully capped the 3-point to 85, which gives us limitless range silver. The handle's kind of easy, I think, for a big, because if you go 76, you get the fast break gold in tier 2, which is awesome on a rebound. And the handle, I bumped it up to a 60 for the vice grip silver, which is great. If you grab a rebound or a pass and you turn, they can't just get it straight away. Defensive. The only bad thing about this build is the players, they think you're being like rebound chaser, Hall of Fame. The block, we went with 88 for the Chase Down Artist Hall of Fame is pretty awesome as well. One of the advice I heard online, like a friend of a friend, they were saying, who's really good, said, don't worry about ball with speed with ball, which I've played this build for about 7 hours today, and I can say that they're correct. We actually leave the speed with ball at 30. The vert 82 is because it gives you it ties in with the driving dunk for the contact and close shot. I just yammed it up to 96. I really did. This is the only build that I was able to find that had fearless finisher Hall of Fame. I'll get to the badges in a minute. I didn't actually realize, but it gives you 4 extra badge points like when you do the first things online. And I threw them all on defense. For the badges, I went with limitless range. So yeah, you get that in the silver and it's just massive. And I went with stuff blocks just because of the cool animations. Yeah, this was the only build I could get gold aerial wizard, Hall of Fame fearless finisher, and gold limitless takeoff. And for some reason in my head, I just wanted all those in the one build and then silver posterized. All right. No, clutch was 1, volume was 2. That's what we went with. But in saying that, like, it's just a good array of badges. They might not be the ones you want, but they're the ones I'm going. And this was all about break starter, so we want that equipped and cored. And then the vice grip silver. And then we threw 1 in bailout. I can only get 1 on the clamp breaker. Special delivery, I just threw on gold because, yeah, it gives us a better success rate with the quick flashy passes or oops. And then for defense, which has 24 badges, I wasn't aware at the time, but you do get another 4 badges when you start using your character, or 25 badges it has, so it'll have near 29 badges if you do dedicate the 4 extras to it. Rebound Chaser Hall of Fame was important, I think, and then Anchor, and then that's obviously core badged and then doubled the points. Anchor on Silver, Brick Wall Bronze, Box Out Beast Gold, Chase Down Artist, which is why we went with the 88 block, have that on Hall of Fame. Interceptor silver, and then ankle braces on the bronze. So that's the build. That is Zach Novak in 2K23, two-way inside-out scorer. I hope you liked it. I hope there's something maybe you picked out of it for your own build. And yeah, I'll just be streaming heaps of this game. Hopefully I can just get back in love with it. All right, catch you guys. Peace.